Good evening. Hey, family. I've got a new story tonight. This one is a special request of Ginger. This was one of her favorite books. It's by Marcus Pfister, and it's called The Rainbow Fish. And it glitters and shines. Let's read this one. The Rainbow Fish by Marcus Pfister. Look at that. How pretty that fish is. A long way out in the deep blue sea, there lived a fish. Not just an ordinary fish, but the most beautiful fish in the entire ocean. His scales were every shade of blue and green and purple, with sparkling silver scales among them. Look at that. The other fish were amazed at his beauty. They called him Rainbow Fish. "Come on, Rainbow Fish," they would call. "Come on, play with us." But the Rainbow Fish would just glide past, proud and silent, letting his scales shimmer. One day, a little blue fish followed after him. "Rainbow Fish," he called, "wait for me. Please give me one of your shiny scales. They are so wonderful, and you have so many." There's the little blue fish, all his rainbow scales. "You want me to give you one of my special scales? Who do you think you are?" cried the rainbow fish. "Get away from me." Shocked, the little blue fish swam away. He was so upset. He told all his friends what had happened. From then on, no one would have anything to do with the rainbow fish. They turned away when he swam by. What good were the dazzling, shimmering scales with no one to admire them? Now he was the loneliest fish in the entire ocean. One day he poured out his troubles to the starfish. "I really am beautiful. Why doesn't anybody like me?" "I can't answer that for you," said the starfish. "But you go beyond the coral reef to a deep cave and you will find the wise octopus. Maybe she can help you." The rainbow fish found the cave. It was very dark inside and he couldn't see anything. Then suddenly two eyes caught him in their glare and the octopus emerged. "I have been waiting for you," said the octopus with a deep voice. "The waves have told me your story. This is my advice. Give a glittering scale to each of the other fish. You will no longer be the most beautiful fish in the sea, but you will discover how to be happy." "I can't," the rainbow fish started to say, but the octopus had already disappeared into a dark cloud of ink. "Give away my scales, my beautiful shiny scales, never. How could I be happy without them?" Such a dilemma. Suddenly he felt the light touch of a fin. The little blue fish was back. "Rainbow Fish, please don't be angry. I just want one little scale." The Rainbow Fish wavered. "Only one very small shimmering scale," he thought. "Well, maybe I wouldn't miss just one." Carefully, the rainbow fish pulled out the smallest scale and gave it to the little fish. Thank you very much. The little blue fish bubbled playfully as he tucked the shiny scale in among his blue ones. A rather peculiar feeling came over the rainbow fish. For a long time, he watched the little blue fish swim back and forth with his new scale glittering in the water. The little blue fish whizzed around the ocean with his scale flashing. So it didn't take long before the rainbow fish was surrounded by other fish, everyone wanting a glittering scale. Look at that. The rainbow fish shared his scales left and right, and the more he gave up, the more delighted he became. When the water around filled him with glimmering scales, he at least felt at home among the other fish. Finally, the rainbow fish had only one shining scale left. His most prized possessions had been given away. Yet, he was very happy. "Come on, rainbow fish," they called. "Come and play with us." "Here I come," said the rainbow fish, and happy as a splash, he swam off to join his friends. But they all have shimmering scales now. And that's the end. The Rainbow Fish by Marcus Finster. Have sweet dreams. Good night.